Welcome back to the corner. In this video, we'll talk about some basic food terms that we usually see on a French menu list. And I'll also include some interesting restaurant names right here in the Philippines. Shout out for our resident cheerleader, Jackie. But just kidding, she's not our cheerleader. She's my office mate, and I hope you're doing well and good today. And you know what? You're one of those strong-willed women that I know of today. It all started when we're having fun at lunchtime, and Jackie suggested to feature different types of salad dressings like the vinaigrette. Vinaigrette is a combination of vinegar, oil, and seasoning used mainly as a salad dressing. And she also suggested to feature some items or food items that are hard to pronounce whenever we order at a restaurant. So I made this video because I can relate to it. I've been one. I literally just pointed at the item and just said the price that I wanted it because I don't know how to say it. I felt awkward, and you know what? It doesn't really matter at all. You don't have to be perfect, or you don't have to perfectly pronounce those words on how they should be. And what's important is that you have to be true to yourself. You know what you want. It doesn't really matter, actually. And the purpose of having this video is just to share and just for learning purposes. And also, the pronunciation will still vary depending on the native language and the native speaker. If you have any suggestions, corrections, and feedback, just let me know in the comments. Feel free to do so. So let's begin. Unlike in a fast food restaurant wherein you get to pay for a single item like your burger or French fries, in a fine dining restaurant or a French restaurant, your meal comes as a set. They have the appetizer, main course, and the dessert. So this is just a sample menu items or meal set that I got from the internet. So when you see un aperitif, it is a cocktail or a pre-dinner drink. Un outre, which means appetizer or your hors d'oeuvre, or starter. Starter being hot or cold. Hot, the soups, cold, the salads. And when you see le plat principal, it's the main course. They also include le fromage, which is cheese, le dessert, which is dessert, le coffee, which is coffee, and then un digestif, which is an after dinner drink, which is usually an alcoholic drink or like brandy, which is served after the meal. And don't be confused with the American entree. It is the main course of the US or American meal, but in French, entree is an appetizer. And also, you will most likely see this drinks that is usually found on certain menu lists in fine dining. You can see le vin rouge, which means red wine, le vin blanc, which means white wine, la bière, which is beer, le champagne, which is champagne, and le coffee, which is coffee, and then le jus de fruit, which is fruit juice. And when it comes to the main course, you'll most likely see these items, which is usually attached to the name of the dish. So when you see la viande, it is meat. And then la volaille, it is poultry. And when you see la bœuf, it is beef. L'agneau, it is lamb. Le pork, which is pork. La poulet, chicken. Les escargots, snails. And le poisson, which is fish. And then for the vegetables, you'll see le légume, le champignon, which is mushroom, and then le pomme de terre, which is potato. And your rice is le riz, and roast pork, you will see le rote de porc. And for le salade, le soup, and le sucre, it's those words stands for salad, soup, and sugar.
Thank you.
on to the interesting restaurant names here in the Philippines. You don't say pho, but it's pho. On the first word, it's like saying fur, but without the R. So you say pho. It is a Vietnamese noodle house. And for the second one, it's more common to say new, but it's Neo by Vikings. Neo means nine in Vikings language. And Senor Pollo. Senor Pollo is the home of the famous Latin chicken, Senor Pollo. And then you don't say Bundi and Berg, but it's Bundai and Berg. Bundai is a famous beach in Sydney, and Berg is one of the busiest streets in Melbourne. It is all about Australian cuisine, Bundai and Berg. You say Dolce Latte. Dolce Latte is a cafe and bake shop in the Philippines, and dolce means sweet in Italian, and latte is milk. And in French, you say La Mer Polar, but you can say La Mer Polard. It is the third Asian branch that you see in SM Aura. The two were opened in Japan. This restaurant is famous for its egg omelette, La Mer Polo. You say tous les jours. Tous les jours means every day in French, and this is a French Asian bakery. You say Rio Ramen and Curry. Rio specializes in ramen, curry, and other Japanese comfort food. For these two, you say Locavor and Provador. Locavor is a Filipino restaurant and bar that uses mostly organic ingredients that is grown locally right here in the Philippines. And Provador is a playful take on the word provider. This is a Western Filipino restaurant. And you say Boulangerie 22. Boulangerie is a bake shop or bakery, which is actually Boulangerie means bakery. And this bakery specializes in artisan breads, pastries, and cakes. Boulangerie 22. And lastly, you don't say cibo, but it's cibo. Cibo means food in Italian. And this is a local restaurant chain owned by Margherita Forres. Cibo. And that's it. If you have enjoyed this video, just go ahead and follow the corner right on Facebook and subscribe to my channel on YouTube. Don't forget to click on the red subscribe button for more videos. The Corner TV with Rihanna. And thank you for watching. See you in the next video. Yes, don't forget my Caesar salad and sprinkle it with a local Eden.